Our goal is only one thing here, to win a championship.
There's a lot of core pieces of the Oilers that are here right now. We can kind of carry that over to Edmonton, and we'll have a lot more success.
What's that? I'm just going to test it for poison.
We can go right to work. I'm excited about everything we have coming ahead.
Good morning, everyone. Don Fehr and I are here to tell you that we have reached an agreement on the framework of a new collective bargaining agreement, the details of which need to be put to paper. We've got to dot a lot of I's, cross a lot of T's. There's still a lot of work to be done.
And hopefully, within just a very few days, the fans can get back to watching people who are skating, and not the two of us.
The Oilers are back.
It's game on, hockey fans. The lockout is over, and the 2013 NHL season is on the horizon.
Surprise Christmas morning. I'm not one of those guys that will be holding out. I'll be first guy lined up for tickets.
The longest stretch I've gone without calling a game since I was 17.
Yes, it's game on. There will be a 2013 NHL season after all.
Thus ends the winter of our discontent. The NHL is back, but easier said than done.
Welcome back, those of you who are returning. The purpose of today's meeting is just to get out on the table any issues we may have.
That 19th home opener, that's an assumption. You don't know for sure.
Edmonton Oilers business operations begin the daunting task of planning a season.
We're in good shape with season seat holders with the new electronic season seat holder cards.
Securing all of our television and radio spots.
A job that normally takes months must now be completed in days.
The first concert is until the 21st. If it gets past that, it's going to get dicey.
We need to test with Derek.
We've already sat down and we made that list. Well, that list has to go from here to about here now.
Octane, good to go?
Octane's good to go.
Any update on car wash and the condensed schedule?
The 12th would be the first day of camp, no on ice, medicals, physicals, etc., car wash, and so on. And the first day on ice would be the 13th of Sunday.
Gilbert and I are working on a we're calling Project Shitting, fan appreciation, player welcome back type of thing. It's a very confidential. Really, at this point, forget we talked about it.
Anything that leaks out before then undermines the whole project. So have a great day, all, and see you tomorrow morning at 7, if not before.
Meanwhile, Hockey Ops has a team to reassemble.
Here we go, Chad.
We don't have any information at this point as far as actual start time. They're talking between the 12th and the 14th. Most likely a start of the season at the 19th. My feeling is, for me, is let's get them in here. Let's get everybody try to get some resemblance of what a real season feels like as soon as possible. They've assured us that it's okay to let the guys in the facilities.
We'll make it down there to see them today and touch base. And
I mean, the sooner the guys can get here, it's better.
Everybody with a stake in the Oilers is dying to finally get this season started.
Good. Jamie? Good, how are you guys doing?
How are you?
It's about time, you know, waiting for this to finally happen. And now it's here, it's kind of surreal.
We just look at what we have up the middle. That's the obvious.
What would be a solution to not having him there?
I think this would be a real, real interesting pair. As much as these guys are developing as a pair, this could be a dynamic pair.
The buzz around this team this year is electric.
Hey!
What did you
say? Got him!
Jersey. Smells like. Hey, it's like, yeah.
Dan, welcome back to the Oilers. Coming out of Jersey.
It smells so good.
Thank you.
After 9 months, the sentiment is unanimous.
I'm going to get way better, man.
Yeah, I'm Oiler.
Drop the puck already. Game on.
That's a heavy side. Let's wait and see. Mikey's got the character, though.
I'm unbelievable.
Yeah. Oh, he's a quality guy. No question.
You got anything else for him? Any other D up there? What do you think of there?
Final preparations for the 2012 NHL entry draft in Pittsburgh's Console Energy Center are well in hand. For the Edmonton Oilers, however, there's less certainty.
This will be my 15th draft and by far the toughest draft. There's so many different parts of the equation this year that I think we're all up at nights trying to piece it together.
As winners of the draft lottery, the Oil will pick first. But who's it going to be? A future franchise defenseman or a winger with blazing speed and a superstar scoring touch?
Well, let's go around the room. We'll start with Heitze.
I think Murray has some of the hockey IQ, skating, the compete level. It's just a guy that you're going to win with, I believe.
I've been around Russian players quite a bit. Ilya Yakupov is the most talented player in the draft. This kid is a good player. And I just see Pavel Bure.
Which player would you pick?
Pick Ilya.
Everybody has their chance to speak. I really may like a fellow. You know, there's other scouts may have a different opinion, and we're here to pick the best player, and we put it in front of the management team, and then they take it, and, you know, the decision would be made.
Halsey?
As far as ranking the best player, the most talented player, and the player that will have the biggest impact in the NHL moving forward would be Yakupov. As Frankie said, you can't teach offense. I mean, he's going to score goals, and scoring goals wins hockey games.
You can mull this over forever and get into a situation where you're just always second-guessing yourself. You get to some point, finally, where you say, hey, the decision is the decision.
You again.
Yeah. I feel good where we're at. I think we've exhausted it to a point where we're where we are.
Do you remember this?
Yeah.
Like it was yesterday. Were you
nervous?
Was I ever?
The Edmonton Oilers are so proud to select from the Sarnia Sting, Dale Yakupov.
We knew that we had to achieve a spot where we could add elite pieces to our organization. He's a dynamic young man on and off the ice. He really is.
Congratulations, buddy.
Thank you.
This is a pretty exciting time for him to be joining this hockey club.
Welcome to the NHL. I remember that line.
With the first pick in the 2012 NHL draft.
Within days of adding an exciting new weapon to their arsenal, the Oilers get another.
Edmonton was always in the back of my mind, like a place I wanted to play with the young talent they have here.
I think you can talk to 29 teams that were vying for him that knew that he would have a good chance to be an impact player. Did we ever expect that we were going to get him? We didn't know. When we heard that he had chosen us, it was more of a confirmation that, you know what, people are seeing what we're doing here.
Summer also has some good people leave the organization.
My reaction, obviously, to not coming back was one of real disappointment.
Tom Rennie's tenure as Oilers head coach is over.
Thanks a lot, everybody. It's okay.
His replacement, a man of the world who already knows this team from top to bottom.
Aside from the technical expertise, which is outstanding, he has the communication level that I think is at an elite level. He really understands the mindset of Canadian players, but he also really understands the background and the differences of what is important to the players that are not from North America.
Looking at the team, we can go right to work. I'm excited about everything we have coming ahead here, Steve.
Our young players and our veteran players, and they're cheering for him. They want Ralph to have success also.
Someone else with strong ties to Edmonton is back in the fold too.
Mac. Officially, welcome back.
Thank you. Over the last 3 years, one of the questions has always been, I see you as an Oiler.
how can you go to another organization? And it's nice to be back on the inside.
The next order of business, NHL free agency.
What's the happy side?
We're just waiting to see. Mikey's got the character though.
Unbelievable.
Yeah. Oh, he's a quality guy, no question. Okay.
With Justin Schultz already signed and sealed in orange and blue, for a change, the Oilers don't feel pressure to pull the trigger on a deal.
I mean, we were fortunate enough to get our guy that we wanted. We'd had our July 1st yesterday.
You got anything else going? Any other deal up there? What are you thinking there?
You know, you got to be careful on a day like today that you don't do anything stupid. We're not desperate, so you can be a little bit more selective.
He's got hands.
Yeah.
If we come out empty today, it's not going to be a bad thing, probably.
Call it a day?
Call it a day.
With July 1st over, attention now turns to the team's annual summer prospects camp.
That's a weird stuff.
You guys are working for your own dinner tonight. Team Copper's cooking dinner for Team Blue. Team Blue's cooking dinner for Team Copper.
Ryan Martindale.
It's vodka.
Trying to prepare the appetizer. It's spinach with some strawberries and some goat cheese, I think. And some honey and balsamic vinegar dressing, I think.
These kids get lessons on hockey Oilers style from assistant farm team coach Rocky Thompson.
Once you hit the top of the circle, you're going to accelerate again through the coach's stick. Remember to get that inside leg out.
Second puck.
Attaboy.
Cut right through my stick.
That's it. That's it. Go to the net. Hard.
You're trying to pop with your free hand pin. If you get him there, you can stick your knee in that spot.
Release.
You guys see how I play him one-on-one?
That's it. Release.
And they get life skills lessons away from the ice.
The idea of whisking is you're turning the finger, adding some air to it. So make sure you're going around the bowl, right?
I've never cooked a stir fry before. Right. I always get my mom or my billets to, so to be able to do this with a bunch of guys, it's pretty fun, it's pretty cool.
Neil Yakupov has lots to learn in the kitchen. But then again, the Oilers didn't draft him to be a chef.
I think I got spicy cowboy. Honestly, I think I messed up because...
What's this orange stuff?
Don't forget your lunch bags.
September again. Thoughts turn to school for some, to hockey for others. Another NHL season is just around the corner.
Eager and excited and hungry to get back at it, sign a new deal, and was looking forward to being back here in Edmonton again. Off-season training is so important to maintain a level of consistency throughout the year. It's nice to be around the guys again to push each other, show them what I've experienced over the years, but also, you know, learn from them too.
Definitely something that the fans don't really see is the summer part of training and workouts. It's probably the most tedious part of the job.
Tedious, maybe. But workouts at Simon Bennett's gym pay off on the ice.
Benny, he's crazy. He sure does love his sleds, and it's almost like you got a D strapped around your back and you're dragging him down the ice.
Hey. To go and train by yourself, it's hard, but if you get an environment like this where there's lots of guys here, your teammates, it's fun to get in this environment and train and trade hard. And like you said, everyone wants to keep up with one another and make sure you're not falling a step behind.
What are you doing?
Benny, come on. The new...
Dubnyk and Jones encounter a curiously named playmate at the dog park.
The one that's owning Doobie's dog over there, that's the Nuge.
You're getting dominated by the Nuge.
There you go, Ben.
Benny, come on.
It's kind of funny that it's named the Nuge. I haven't seen any Jonesy dogs out here, so I guess I'm not that important.
An otherwise perfect afternoon in the park sees a black cloud looming. Oh, yeah. Oilers training camp is set to open, but only if there's a new CBA in place. The signals from the league and Players Association don't sound hopeful.
it's unfortunate the situation that we're in this year. Coming back, it sucks not feeling like we're going to get started on time.
It's frustrating, and I'm not sure that any team feels the way that we do right now. It's almost sad and wrong to not be playing hockey games with that much talent in your lineup.
When you play so hard, practice so hard, train so hard to get to a high level, you want to play.
Lockout on. While other NHL teams watch their stars scatter in the wind, the keys to the Oilers' present and future ride it out together in Oklahoma City.
It's easier than walking. Didn't want to buy a car or anything. You never know how long it's going to last.
Uphill both ways?
It's not too bad. Definitely getting our lactic acid out a lot easier.
Oh, it's actually hot. I'm sweating.
I know.
It's nice to have a routine down.
Yeah. I'll get salmon sashimi.
Salmon sashimi?
We do the same thing every day. Practice, bike to practice, eat, play Call of Duty, sleep. Yeah. Which one's that?
I think so.
Spicy cowboy and sashimi.
Yeah, I think I got spicy cowboy. I don't know. Honestly, I think I messed up because... What's this orange stuff?
Eggs.
Fish eggs? You know what it looks like, and you know that.
Life in OKC is good, but these guys aren't exactly here in the Midwest for the seafood.
Yeah, we have a really good young team down here. It's good.
I think it's better. They're starting to win. Probably helps a little bit, even though we had a hell of a practice today.
All right, it's going to work. 3-on-3 down low. Good stick. Good. Play two, Marty. Play two. Got a boy. Get up deep. That's it, guys. Stretch it out.
Can you have higher talent in your practices? The players that are here, they learn from it. They get to practice against it. And it makes everybody better as a group.
Win that battle, let's go! Sick. That was filthy.
Little money in the bank, 6:30s. This is the difference between winning and losing in overtime. After you do your 30 seconds, I want you to do 5 push-ups. Next time you do 5 sit-ups, get the work done.
That's the way, boys. All right, 5 push-ups. That's it, guys. Push, push, push.
They're all the same age. They've been to prospect camps. They've been to development camps together. They know each other. And so this is a great opportunity because hopefully in the future they're all playing together and helping the Edmonton Oilers win the championship.
Great job, boys. Great job.
I think it was a tough adjusting to the league.
Not for Schulte.
Yeah, except for Schulte.
Everything Schulte touches, it goes in.
Schulte's near circle. Shooting score! Schulte with his league-leading 22nd point.
3 of these amigos are already well-known around the NHL. But the new guy has quickly shown that he's no slouch either.
Justin is a special player. He's a defenseman that has offensive capabilities. And obviously, he's showing that right now. He has great instincts. He has good stick, plays well defensively. We're very fortunate to have this guy because I think he's going to be a standout. You know, for him to go to Edmonton right away, there'll be a lot of pressure on him through the media. And here in Oklahoma City, he's able to come here, work on this game. Obviously, he's doing well. When given the opportunity to move up to the National Hockey League, I think the transition for him will be a lot easier since he's played here. And he's playing with guys he's going to play with up in Edmonton. And so it's a fantastic opportunity for him.
It's been a blast so far. You know, we're all living around the same area, so we hang out a lot. It's been a lot of fun. So we're all young, and, you know, we can all find some chemistry. And, you know, we're only going to get better as we get older. So it should be interesting.
These 4 might be world-class athletes on the ice, but off it, they're just big kids.
This is one of the funniest videos I've ever gotten.
Mardi
Gras?
Thank you.
What's that?
Surf
salad. That was awesome. I'm just gonna test it for poison. Just, I'll let you know if there's any poison in here.
Apologies.
Yeah.
They just didn't put my order.
He's like, hey, where's my food? This guy's like,
You ordered? Yeah, Nuge didn't get a whole lot of respect on that trip.
Do you guys need anything else?
Tequila salad. Right there.
That's classic Nuge right there.
No, I'm good.
For, like, whatever reason, I always order the worst rolls. I want some of that surf and turf. I gotta get some good shows for the road trip. How long? We got, like, a 9-hour bus tomorrow or something? Get the bathroom in here.
Then you get the older guys back here, like Colton Tubert.
The King's Domain is right here.
Wow, Maggie. Nice dressed up, eh?
Every good bus tour needs a tour guide.
Walk in here. This is where the coaches usually sit. You got their TV right there.
And a TV right here.
Throw some of the rookies up here as well.
We got some ice in here.
And there's a fridge right here. Look at that.
Water and Gatorade.
Hey. Nice, eh?
All these fold down. How many bucks are on here?
Dupes.
304.
Three. I think there's like 26 bucks or something.
Get the bathroom in here.
Then you get the older guys back here, like Colton Tubert.
The King's Domain is right here.
In Arco.
Oh. It's way too early, Sergio. Way
yeah.
Too early.
You know, what time is it now?
It's too early.
9 o'clock. And then we got a TV back there and a TV there. We got satellite that works half the time. And guys, you should play cards back here or do whatever.
It's not bad.
We're on our way down to Austin, Texas. It's about a 6-hour bus ride from Oklahoma City. We've got a little bit more of an empty bus than we normally have today with some injuries. Guys meeting us down in Austin. 26 on the bus today, but a pretty comfortable ride for us.
So what do you got?
I brought Office Space, the best of Eddie Murphy on Saturday Night Live, and the best of Chris Farley on Saturday Night Live, and then Arrested Development.
From sitcoms on the bus, the jokes at the rink, the OKC coaches try to keep their young team loose.
Schultzy, you look like Pablo Escobar with that mustache.
Yeah? It's getting greasy now.
Looking good.
I love it. You know, they're really, they're players' coaches. You know, I think we all have a pretty good relationship with them.
Now and then I think, why is our record not better? Boys, we go and score some goals. Now we're ready to go on a roll. Here we go!
And they're smart too. We have some good systems in place, and you know you can talk to them about anything.
Taylor Hall in the near corner, domestic guy away from Mueller.
It's a good opportunity that why they're here. We can show them some stuff and take every opportunity to just point some things out.
Make that forecheck and make a decision. Peel off and then Yanni just over, or if he takes you, up.
So each player has access to the shifts, things that they did well, things that they need to improve on, and we'll lay voice tracks over it, just habits that they need to develop or things that they did well that we want to expand on.
Go to self-evaluation. And then it'll say if you want to do this on an iPhone, click here, and then click that here.
Well, they all watch them. They want feedback instantly. They all want to watch their shifts, and they all want to get better and improve. And not only do guys get information on their shifts, but they can interact with one another. It's almost like a Facebook for Edmonton Oilers players. It's absolutely amazing.
It says I'm on 255 of 8,184.
8,000, dude?
What was it? That's $5.
Oh, that's all five?
Yeah.
Well, still, that's ridiculous.
You're not actually going to finish that, though.
In my life, I will.
For Jordan, Taylor, and Ryan to ride the bus here, it's not foreign to them. They played Canadian junior hockey, which has very tough travel, especially in the Western League. You know, obviously, like, we don't charter jets, but we do charter buses, so. It's the same thing as chartering with a plane. The only thing is, when you're on a bus, it's a really long runway. So the thing is that not as big of adjustment as people think from a culture standpoint in the locker room. I think the bigger adjustment was just playing in the American League. You know, the American Hockey League is a very good league. People that underestimate it have a hard time with it.
It was a tough time adjusting it. For me and Nuge and Halsey now, it's a different league, and we hadn't played a game in 7 or 6 months or whatever it was.
The American Hockey League, don't call those. Hudson Bay rules.
There's a lot of core pieces of the Oilers that are here right now, guys that are, you know, going to be big parts of the team in the future.
If you try to go strong side, I tried to get that puck, and you can back off.
Yeah. Over to Hartikainen, and he sent it to Piarvi down low. Centered it, Fadoon, score!
I mean, OCS 4, and, you know, we got Magnus, and we got Hartikainen, and there's quite a few guys. We're bonding.
Coconut water, that's pretty good beer, I heard.
Of course, for a bunch of 20-somethings, bonding usually involves a whole lot of beaking.
Maggie, can I have a drink?
No. Look at Swedish people.
You come here to visit Swedish guys, you'll never get anything. So, not even a glass of water.
Ay, 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 ay.
Which one are better? You?
I don't know what to say.
They're pretty even. I'm more like a runner. I just run around and try to kill everyone. They're kind of camping.
Yeah, you do. We're snipers.
Yeah, I know exactly.
When you play in the American Hockey League, there's no first among equals. Everybody humps gear on the road.
It's really good for these guys just on a daily basis to keep playing, keep being in a competitive environment. The American Hockey League's a great league, and you've certainly seen that this year with the competition.
You know, we're playing on a nice surface that's the same size as the NHL, and a league that is, you know, a lot of grinding and a lot of the same stuff you'll see in an NHL game, so we'll be a lot more prepared for it than a lot of other guys will be.
We go into games here, and there's a lot of pressure on us, but we should expect to win. We have that good of a team, so I think if we can kind of carry that over to Edmonton, we'll have a lot more success.
That's, you know, why I chose to play here is because, you know, I get to play with these guys, and, you know, it's great potential to win Stanley Cups here and, you know, have a lot of success, so I'm just excited to get it started.
Hockey didn't exactly disappear during the NHL lockout, but let's admit it, January in Edmonton is a better month with the Oilers than without them.
Hello.
With players trickling in, it's a time of happy reunions and friendly first encounters.
Good. How you doing, buddy?
Good.
Good. Nice to see you again.
Oh,
Mr. Schultz, meet Mr. Schultz.
Welcome back.
There you go, boys.
Mr. Yakupov, meet your fans.
Hey, good luck this year, eh? We're going to come watch the game.
Perfect.
What are you playing for?
Oilers.
I hope.
Oh, you're Yakupov?
Yeah.
Oh, I just come from Ukraine, eh?
Oh, right on.
Yeah. Dobro utro.
Shields are weak.
It's great ice in the world. In the
Justin Schultz got off the ice and said, holy, that ice was amazing.
Yeah.
Well, bud, in about a week and a bit, when you play your first game, you're going to be like, holy cow. It's a great place to play. Fans are crazy. They love their Oilers.
My favorite hotel.
Yep.
Welcome.
How are you?
Good.
Job. Good morning.
What's up, man? Good, you?
Yes.
Ryan Harrison. Nice
to meet you.
How are you doing, bud?
Where are you from?
The Utah. Bring them up to me. I'll work on them when you're done.
Welcome back. Yes. Good to see you.
Thanks for showing up, buddy. Holy, are you kidding me?
Good job on the world junior.
Oh, Jesus. You didn't even get past
No, like, personally, like, seriously, he played very well. Like,
oh, yeah, he did personally, yeah.
Are you serious? He was really good.
Yeah.
Well, thank you, then.
It's unbelievable. I've been to Vegas. Like I said, he brought it back from Spangler instead of mine.
While a jet-lagged goalie returns to Rexall Place as Spangler Cup champ, a jet-lagged rookie experiences an historic moment of his own.
Can we go on?
Anytime you want, buddy.
Thank you.
This first time?
Yeah.
First time right here. Welcome.
For a hockey player, there's no better feeling than hitting the ice with your teammates. Any ice, anytime. You never know when a game might suddenly break out.
Thank God for Twitter, that's how we know it's here.
Can you wait till the season's to start?
Oh, hell no, I can't wait. Sorry for saying it. I'm excited, I'm totally excited.
Yeah. We need him.
We need him.
Paul, I'll do it. Yes.
Smitty.
Hey, do we have like a long bus ride ahead of us?
This is sweet.
Want to get pops available?
All right, gentlemen, let's do it.
It's unreal here, just because this is kind of brings you back to being a kid, and to start the season like this, I think it's pretty special. It is cold, but it's a lot of fun. Anyone else's fingers cold?
A lot of games in a short period, you know, so we might have to rest some guys and give me a chance up front.
Emmy, stay up! Stay up!
What's up, brother?
Yeah, look at it.
Hey, how sick is this?
It's unreal. Yeah.
Captain,
yeah. Great season last week.
Thanks for coming, buddy. Thanks, everybody.
You get called up here to camp, and you guys want to stay. That's always the norm. And we've made some decisions right now.
together, just me and you, buddy. Let's go.
Be it September or January, one of the rites of NHL training camp is the annual picture day or car wash.
That's it, that's all? That's all you got?
Yeah. I'm on Twitter, are you? Follow me at...
Players hit the circuit for press guide photo shoots, social media feeds, sponsor and broadcaster promos.
Who do I follow?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, Maggie.
This is all country.
That guy in a little coat.
I love that music. I don't want to show you the picture, but I have Oklahoma driver's license now.
This is to show my kids in 10 years that I actually played in the NHL with some of the best players in the league, and that daddy was on the ice and basically helped shape the young Oilers in the future.
Have you seen that show before?
Yeah. You're listening to Oilers Now with Bob Stauffer on 630 Ched.
630 Chedsies, where I put the puck all the time.
Schultzy just goes like this. But I love your songs.
Get in my belly.
Business affairs concluded. The Oilers take to the ice. An open practice in front of several thousand eager and curious fans.
This is great. No, we're going to have fun. We're going to have fun, then. Keep going,
Pat. With only 6 days until the season opens, there's lots to teach and lots to learn.
Let's go, boys.
But then, every other team is in exactly the same boat. After almost half a season together in Oklahoma City, the Hall Everly Nugent Hopkins line is ready to go.
Move it. Good job, Maggie.
But success this season will require scoring depth. There's lots of promise in the line featuring Alish Hemsky, Neil Yakupov.
It's a good save, Javi.
And center, Sam Gagne.
New wheels falling all over the place. Wheels.
I get a chance to play with guys like Alish and Neil, and they have so much skill, and, you know, I feel like I can really help them out and you know, reaching their offensive potential.
It's the biggest thing, difference-wise, big ice to small ice. Small ice, you have to support the puck everywhere. Big ice, you can just spread it out, right?
You know, I think we were going to be able to develop some chemistry there, and we have a chance here to turn things around, and, you know, that's exciting for all of us.
I was playing that with Krejci.
Okay.
In check.
Yeah.
He was high, I was low, but I was coming in the middle.
Okay.
And I was kind of squeezed around.
Yeah. We have to make sure that we consistently bring the same level of swagger every game, where we know that, you know, we're the team to beat, and that's starting to come around in the room, and, you know, we're excited for that.
A short week passes quickly. The intensity of practice is ramped up to simulate game action. But for one veteran, the season looms up just a little too quickly.
How'd you do?
Still recovering from off-season surgery, Nikolai Habibulin is not quite ready to play. Until he is, OKC starter Jan Denny will back up Devan Dubnyk. Meanwhile, another farmhand is poised to make the big club this year.
How are you doing, Hardy?
Good.
You've come a long way this year.
I know what I have to do. I listen to a lot of coaches, and they say that I have to play my own game, be a power forward, hit the guys, drive to the net, screen the goalie, play your own game. It's not easy job to stand in front there and get those sticks behind your back and get slashes all the time. My hands are pretty broken all the time, but it's worth it. It's when you score a goal in front of the net when you've been hacked all game, so I'm feeling better when I play like that.
You've played more consistent by far, you know. You deserve where you are in this lineup right now, you know. Have some fun, Hardy, huh? Huh? Oh, it's good.
Three other Barons, however, are headed back to OKC.
Awesome. You look at the situation, you get called up here to camp and you guys want to stay. That's always the norm. And we've made some decisions right now. You're going to be going back down to OKC today. But we wanted you to be part of the team building. We wanted you to feel the system, the changes we've made.
You know, all three of us feel we can be up here and play up here, you know, regularly. But obviously, a lot of bodies up here, so it's understandable. Just go down there and work hard
hopefully try to get back up here.
Like you said, it was nice to get to see the speed and how the game's played at this level, so hopefully we'll be back.
Yeah, for sure. And Tubes, for you?
It was nice to be back with NHLers. I mean, I got to finish the season here, so
yeah.
I just keep getting hungrier and hungrier. I want to stay.
This is good. This is going to be a season with a lot of games, and we need a lot of bodies, and we need specials. So just keep your mind prepared and work on the things.
It's always hard to be sent down. But these guys now know they're not very far from the NHL. Chances are pretty good they'll be back before spring.
Jonesy, you got breakfast.
As camp nears an end, the Oilers swing a trade with Dallas, bringing home a hard-hitting local boy to beef up their blue line.
Camera's rolling.
You know, I'm coming in here to crash and bang and be kind of a physical presence.
How about a little bit faster? Yeah, just a little bit faster.
Who's directing?
Oh, sorry.
You know, when I get my chance, I can go in and bring what the team needs, and that's physicality.
You got a smile in the next one.
Yeah. Mine with a smile.
Teeth and everything.
They just said no smile.
Yeah. Well, the first two, you got to look tough.
Got to have an option.
Oilers fans like tough.
Yeah, they like tough.
That's why they like Nuge so much.
Okay, count it in.
Three,
camera's rolling.
Two, one. See? He's a natural.
It's beautiful, eh?
Yep.
Yeah, he is natural.
Time's up, gentlemen. The Oilers are as ready as they're going to get now. First up, Vancouver. The Oilers' season begins in GM Place, home of the defending President's Cup trophy winners. Coming off an opening night loss to Anaheim right here 24 hours earlier, the Canucks would love to pay it forward.
Guys, we all know there's going to be a storm at the beginning of the game. Let us be the reason for it. Let us be that storm. Let everybody get going right off the bat here.
Come on, here.
Be ready to push back and push back hard.
Come on, go, ball.
Come on, Laddie, here we go.
Our end, the battle. They're in the battle.
Come on, dude. Come on, dude.
Be ready to push back and push back hard. Make your first shifts count. Devin Dubnyk, shut that door. Let's go, boys.
Get hard. Third line up there now, causing havoc. Orkov stopped by Luongo.
Wait, what? Gotta play. Play down there, boys. Keep it low.
The visitors play hard, but late in the second period, they find themselves down 2-0. This is a movie both teams have seen before. But who said a tired old script can't be rewritten?
Here's Jordan Everly with a backhand, and he scores the first goal of the season for the Oilers.
With his team only down by one now,
here is Weiss, and a quick save by Dubnyk.
Devin Dubnyk shuts that door.
Can we have a clear?
Yeah.
We're just shooting it down.
Make it uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Edmonton forces overtime.
Right side comes Gagne. Drop pass for Hemsky. Hemsky cutting for the net. Hemsky scores! Alex Hemsky ties this game at two.
Then takes Vancouver to a shootout. Goalie coach Fred Chabot heads up a brand new unit this year.
Alex Hemsky, the second shooter.
He picks the shooters.
Yeah, tell those boys, don't think, just shoot.
Good idea.
Just do your thing.
Come here, against the wall.
Lots of moves upstairs, and he scores.
Yes!
What a shot.
The boys.
For the victory. Alex Hemsky scores! The Oilers win their season opener!
Freddie's not here yet, but I think the new specialty team's off to a great start. Is there a team in this league we can't beat, guys?
No, there's not one team.
Great character, great work all together. I really think this is a special start for us, and everybody worked their asses off, never gave up on anything. You know, the character that we showed here today is what we're going to build this group on. Remember this one for one thing, and it's going to be hard every night like this. Let's inhale that, guys, and we go right back at her tomorrow. Thank you very much for that start.
We have 99 days, 48 games, 24 travel days. Put those numbers together, it's going to be an extremely challenging time. This is a really tough run to the top eight, and the Western Conference is on any given night. There's no freebies, there's no easy night.